Hello there, everybody. Amber Hawkins, your computer needs a Toledo LLC, celebrating year number 13 of computer training more that comes to you. Happy 2018 to everybody. How are you? As you can see, I'm kind of dressed, warm because although it's warmed up where I am, that doesn't necessarily mean that there are cold elements to not deal with. I wanted to come to you quickly. I'm kind of late bringing this information to you, and I apologize for that. But wanted to bring up some information as far as computers, technology, and the winter weather. Something I've done before, but I wanted to bring up this again. Because in some areas, it's similar to what it is out here in Toledo, Ohio, where I am. And in other areas, there's a lot of snow, a lot of cold, wind chill factors and all of that. Electronics, computers, whatever the case may be. If you have them outside in the garage or whatever, and it's not the temperatures of, let's say, above 30 degrees or whatever, or actually in that environment, you need to bring them in immediately. Any time you have electronics and it's freezing outside, below 5 degrees, 0 degrees, whatever the case may be, those are not the temperatures for electronics, computers, and the like. Bring them inside. As far as attempting to try to operate or plug them in or whatever, do not do that because they are going to need time to warm up. They're going to need time to have maintenance possibly performed on them to see if they operate correctly. There's going to be the time frame needed to do any, in case there's any repairs, because cold weather like this can damage electronics, can damage computers, can damage servers and all of that, can damage even small devices such as jump drives, thumb drives, even your smartphones and the like. You also have to consider, when it comes to winter weather, any coverings, any layers of protection necessary for that. Because if you're going to be operating any devices in winter weather, you need to have the protection necessary for those devices. For instance, I know drones are pretty much a lot of what people are doing now. Whatever protective gear you need for your drone, make sure you have that. What protective gear you have for your drone is not going to be the same as protective gear for your smartphones or for cable, let's say, for putting in any buildings for construction, houses, or whatever the case may be, and the use of the technologies necessary to get that performance and to get that done. To the one person, hello, how are you? You're going to have to consider as well. I mentioned warranties before, but the coverage and protection of your devices, of whatever you're using. Protection, is it for weather purposes? Rain, sleet, snow, Mother Nature. You might be operating a device and for some reason an accident happens and now your device is damaged. Do you have warranty and protection for that? Check your warranty terms. You're going to have to make sure of that. Your devices, if they have been damaged, they're going to have to be repaired, including any data that you may have saved in your hard drive. Hard drives can be damaged by winter weather. Are there plans for backing up that data? Are there plans for protecting that data? That data needs to be protected. That data needs to be stored somehow. That's why there are different cloud services. That's why there are different ways of doing so. And I'm going to conclude by saying, as far as bringing in devices to make sure they're maintained, you have to keep them away from the cold, but at the same time, don't have them near an area where you're trying to let the device warm up. It's near a heated area or a very hot area, because that can damage it as well. There's an in-between, and a lot of devices, when you read them, when you purchase them, if they say that they cannot be out in inclement weather such as this, make sure you follow manufacturer's instructions and suggestions. That also includes any devices, no matter how small, no matter how large. Any questions, 419-304-4564. Contact linkofyourcomputerneeds.net. The site is still being updated, so look out for that. Second phase of updates probably to be completed sometime after the Martin Luther King holiday. Maybe before, but we're going to have to see. Also, if you have any questions, you can reach out to me, Facebook, LinkedIn, Twitter, YouTube, StumbleUpon, Pinterest, if you have any additional questions. Again, Amber Hawkins, Your Computer Needs a Toledo LLC, celebrating your number 13 of Computer Train, the more that comes to you. Take care. Again, happy 2018. And please, please, whatever you do, be careful, unless you have protection. And as I said before, again, unless you have the skill set and knowledge to do so, as far as electronic devices, smartphones, laptops, any devices as far as with technology, this type of weather, you have to have that special care. Don't leave it out here unless it's designed for that. Make sure there's protection. If you have to have an inclement weather or dangerous winter chills like this, keep your dad protected. Take care. Bye-bye.